Key findings from the Philippines National Demographic and Health Survey 2017. The Philippines National Demographic and Health Survey 2017, or NDHS, is designed to provide up-to-date estimates of basic demographic and health indicators for the Philippines. The NDHS 2017 is the sixth NDHS survey implemented between 1993 and 2017. 27,496 households and 25,074 women age 15 to 49 were successfully interviewed in the NDHS 2017. This represents a response rate of 99% for households and 98% for women. The NDHS 2017 provides estimates at the national level, for urban and rural areas, and for each of the 17 administrative regions in the Philippines. The survey results show that the Philippines has made progress in demographic and health indicators over time. Fertility in the Philippines has decreased from 4.1 children per woman in 1993 to 2.7 children per woman in 2017. This means that women in the Philippines currently have, on average, about 3 children. More than half of married women age 15 to 49 use a method of family planning. 40% use a modern method, and 14% use a traditional method. The pill is the most popular modern method, while withdrawal is the most popular traditional method. More women are using family planning. Modern method use has increased from 25% in 1993 to 40% in 2017. Traditional method use has changed little since 1993. Unmet need for family planning is defined as the proportion of married women who want to delay or stop childbearing but are not using family planning. In the Philippines, 17% of married women have an unmet need for family planning. Unmet need for family planning has declined by nearly half from 30% in 1993 to 17% in 2017. The NDHS 2017 also measured childhood mortality. More children in the Philippines are surviving early childhood than ever before. Under 5 mortality is the probability of a child dying before their 5th birthday. In the Philippines, under 5 mortality has decreased by half from 54 deaths per 1,000 live births in 1993 to 27 deaths per 1,000 live births in 2017. Still, this means that 1 in every 37 children dies before their 5th birthday. Antenatal care coverage in the Philippines is improving. Nearly all Filipino women receive antenatal care from a skilled provider such as a doctor, nurse, or midwife. The timing and quality of antenatal care are also important. Since 1993, more Filipino women are attending 4 or more antenatal care visits and beginning antenatal care within their first trimester as recommended. Delivering in a health facility decreases risk for both mothers and newborns. Nationwide, more than 3 in 4 births are delivered in a health facility. Health facility deliveries have nearly tripled since 1993, when only 28% of births were delivered in a health facility. While this is very good news, still, 20% of births are delivered at home, putting mothers and babies at risk. PhilHealth is the most common form of health insurance coverage. Overall, 2/3 of the household population in the Philippines are covered by PhilHealth insurance. PhilHealth coverage has increased from 38% in 2008 to 66% in 2017. While the NDHS 2017 reports progress in many areas, challenges remain. Basic vaccination coverage has fluctuated over time, rising from 72% in 1993 to 80% in 2008 before declining to 70% in 2017. Still, 7 in 10 children aged 12 to 23 months in the Philippines have received all 8 basic vaccinations. Nearly all women in the Philippines have heard of HIV/AIDS, but less than half know where to get an HIV test. Knowledge of where to get an HIV test increases with household wealth, from 32% of women in the poorest households to 59% of women in the wealthiest households. The NDHS 2017 provides insights into violence against women. In the Philippines, 1 in 4 ever-married women aged 15 to 49 have experienced spousal violence, whether physical, sexual, or emotional. Ever-married women's experience of spousal violence has changed little since 2008. As you can see, the Philippines National Demographic and Health Survey 2017 provides a wealth of information about the population and health situation in the Philippines. Results of the survey show where progress has been made, as well as areas for improvement. The NDHS 2017 was implemented by the Philippine Statistics Authority. Funding for the NDHS 2017 was provided by the Government of the Philippines. The United States Agency for International Development provided technical assistance and equipment through ICF under the DHS program, a project that assists countries in the collection of data to monitor and evaluate population, health, and nutrition programs. Since 1993, an NDHS has been implemented in the country approximately every 5 years under the DHS program. For additional information on the results of the NDHS 2017, please contact the Philippine Statistics Authority and the DHS program.